When I first came to Vietnam, there were many things that I misunderstood or was confused about.
How was that? Was that good? Be honest now.
I know, I sound exactly like I am from Wales. So here are five things that I misunderstood when I first came to Vietnam. Number one, commenting about appearances.
Em chào chị.
Chào em.
Em này khỏe không chị?
Chị khỏe. Em khỏe không?
Dạ khỏe.
Ý dạo này bị mập phải không?
Dạ.
Thấy em hơi mập nha.
Dạ tại vì nhà thì ở nhà dịch đâu làm gì đâu.
Mập đó. Giảm cân đi nha. Mập quá là không tốt đâu đó.
Dạ.
Nhưng mà nhìn cũng đẹp trai đó. Chỉ có điều hơi mập thôi.
So in Vietnam, the first thing people will do is comment about your appearance. Especially if you haven't seen them in a long time, they'll make a comment about how your appearance has changed. But don't take it to heart. It's supposed to be a sign of caring. But yeah, nobody asked. Number two, confusing hand signals.
Hey.
Okay.
Hey. Đi đâu vậy?
So in America, this means come here. And this means go away. But in Vietnam, this means come here. And this means go away. You can see now why I was confused. And this means hit the like button if you like the video and hit subscribe while you're at it. Don't forget to hit that bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. Number three, accepting money.
Cảm ơn chị đã giúp em nha.
Không có gì đâu em.
Dạ, em có này cho chị nè.
Hả? Ủa gì vậy?
Gửi cho chị nha. Tại vì em chị cũng giúp em nhiều.
Trời ơi.
Thôi lấy đi chị.
Thôi.
Lấy đi.
Thôi mà.
À, ok, cho em dẹp hết. À, có gì thì em về trước nha.
Giờ lại giữ gìn sức khỏe nha.
À. Ủa? Đi thiệt hả?
In Vietnam, it's polite to refuse money a few times before taking it. Usually, if you give someone money, they will refuse it twice before finally accepting it. If they keep refusing it after a third time, it means they don't want your money. But if you're adamant on giving it to them, you can hide it in their purse, in their pocket, or somewhere in their home. Number four, being open with talking about your salary.
Ủa em ơi, làm tháng lương được nhiêu cho em?
Dạ, cũng đủ sống chị.
Đủ sống là bao nhiêu?
Ờ, thì giờ thì nhà có một mình em thôi thì tiền thì đủ xài đủ cho em đó.
10 triệu không?
Thì cũng cỡ cỡ đó chị.
Em đừng có ngại, chị đâu có nhiều chuyện đâu em. Chuyện ai nấy biết thôi, chứ không có nhiều chuyện, chứ ít khi hỏi người ta lắm. Ví dụ như chị thương chị mới hỏi thôi. À, nếu mà lương em nhiều thì chị mừng cho em, chắc 20 triệu phải không?
Vietnamese people have no shame asking you about your salary. Honestly, I haven't really figured out the correct way to go about this. Like in the skit, you can see I say like enough to live off of. It's a weird subject to really talk about. So yeah, I don't really have an answer here. Sorry. Okay, number five, paying for women. That actually sounds very weird now that I say it out loud. I mean like going out and paying for them, paying for the bill. Okay, when going out, it's kind of customary for the guys to pay for the lady's portion. So if it's a double date, it's kind of easy math because the guy will pay for his girlfriend's bill or his date's bill. If it's a guy that's third wheeling, the third wheel will pay for himself and the other guy will pay for himself and his girlfriend. If it's two girls and one guy, then the guy will pay for everything. But there are women that will pay for things in a different way. For example, if you pay for the movie tickets, she will pay for the popcorn. Sometimes it's like that and sometimes it's not. So just be prepared. And so those were some things that confused me when I first came to Vietnam. I hope you liked the video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Peace. If I take it down, would you really hold me down and be your best friend? She just wanna hit me with a quickie.